Welcome to a video on multiplying radical expressions. To multiply two radicals with the same index, multiply the coefficients together and multiply the radicands together and then simplify. So as you can see here, we have p and q outside the radicals. Those will be the coefficients. So we multiply those together. And then we have u and v as our radicands, the numbers or expressions underneath the radicals. We multiply this together and they stay underneath the radical. And then we'll have to simplify this if we can. Let's go ahead and try some. So on number one, the coefficients of these two square roots are 1. So we really only have to multiply the radicands together. So we would have the square root of 75 times 6. Now we do have to simplify this, so I wouldn't actually multiply these together. What I'll do now is break these down into their prime factors. Since we are looking for perfect square factors, if you know your perfect squares, you may be able to take some shortcuts here, but I'm going to show detailed steps. So 75 is 25 times 3. 3 is prime. 25 is 5 times 5. And then for 6, we have the factors of 2 and 3. So let's go ahead and rewrite this in prime factored form. We'll put these factors in order. So we have 1 factor of 2, and we have a factor of 3 here and a factor of 3 here. That's 2 factors of 3, and then we have 2 factors of 5. So it's very helpful if we put these in order from least to greatest. Now the index is 2, so we're looking for the perfect square factors. There's a perfect square, and there's a perfect square. So in simplified form, this would be 3, and this would be 5. So 3 times 5 on the outside, and the inside we have the square root of 2, which is 15 square root 2. Okay, and number 2, we'll first multiply the coefficients together. That would be 12. Then we'd have the square root of 5 times 5. Since 5 times 5 is a perfect square, this simplifies to 12 times 5, which is equal to 60. Let's go ahead and try a couple more. Again, we'll start by multiplying the coefficients together. Then we'll multiply our radicands together. So in the first step, we'd have 4x times 3, that's 12x. And then underneath the square root, we're going to have 27x cubed times 6x to the fifth. What we're going to do now is rewrite all of this in prime factored form and then see how we can simplify it. Let's look at 27 first. You may already know this, but 27 is equal to 3 factors of 3, and of course 6 is 2 times 3. So the prime factorization of this product, 27 times 6, we would have 1 factor of 2 and 4 factors of 3. Next, x to the third times x to the fifth, that would be x to the eighth. But since our index is 2, we'll write x to the eighth as x to the second times x to the second times x to the second times x to the second. Again, I'm trying to keep it consistent. We're always going to be forming groups of two equal factors. Let's go ahead and show that now. There's a perfect square factor. There's one. And then we have four groups of x squared. So what we're going to have is this 12x times, we'll have 3 times 3 times x times x times x times x. Outside the radical, that's going to be 9x to the fourth times the square root of, looks like, the only thing left is 2. Now we go ahead and multiply this together. 12 times 9, that's going to be 108. X to the fifth, square root 2. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at number 4. Now we're going to have to distribute, but the rules stay the same. Notice all the coefficients are 1, so we just need to multiply the radicands together. So we're going to have the cube root of 9 times 4 minus the cube root of 9 times 3. Let's go ahead and rewrite all of this in prime factored form so we can simplify it. We can do this one in our head. 4 would be 2 times 2, and 9 would be 3 times 3. 9 would be 3 times 3, and then we have another factor of 3. We can see this first cube root doesn't simplify, but this one does. There's 3 factors of 3. So we're going to have the cube root of 36 minus, this would just be 3. Let's talk about conjugates now. The expression a plus the square root of b and a minus the square root of b are called conjugates of each other. Notice that they differ only in the sign between the terms. One is addition and one is subtraction. The product of two conjugates is the difference of two squares, and this result is very helpful when simplifying radical expressions that contain a sum or difference in the denominator, which we'll see in the video for division of radical expressions. But let's go ahead and take a look at a couple examples of what happens when you multiply conjugates together. Again, we should notice these are conjugates because the terms are the same. One's a sum and one's a difference. Let's just go ahead and FOIL this out like we normally would. Square root of 3 times the square root of 3, that would be square root of 9. Next, we'll have the square root of 3 times a negative square root 5, that would be minus square root 15. The next product would be square root 5 times square root 3, that's plus square root 15. And then the last product, we have positive square root 5 times negative square root 5, that's minus the square root of 25. Let's go ahead and simplify this. These two terms are opposites. The square root of 9 is 3, and the square root of 25 is 5, and this would give us negative 2. So we multiply these conjugates together, and notice how the square roots were eliminated. Let's go ahead and try one more. So one of the patterns that we'll see when we multiply conjugates like this together is the first term comes from these first two terms squared minus the square of the second terms. That's nothing we need to memorize because we can always just multiply it out. Let's go ahead and try another. For this first product, we'll have 2 square root 7 times 2 square root 7. That would be 4 square root of 7 times 7, or square root of 49, minus 2 square root 7 times square root 3. That would be 2 square root 21. Now this third product is going to be a positive 2 square root 21. And the last product will be minus the square root of 3 times 3, or the square root of 9. So one of the things that we'll notice after we do a few of these is that when you multiply conjugates together, the two middle terms will always be opposites. And if we simplify these, the square root of 49 is 7, so 4 times 7 is 28, minus the square root of 9 would be 3, it's equal to 25. We'll work with these conjugates again when we divide radicals. I hope you found this video helpful.